guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to share 5 of my simple health and wellness hacks. These are things that I personally do in my own life that just make living a healthy lifestyle just a little bit easier, a little bit more convenient, more fun, enjoyable, and I thought it would be fun to just sit down and have a chat about them, and maybe they're going to be helpful in your life as well. A few of these things are actually newer things that I've recently started doing that I have found really, really beneficial. So some of these you guys might have heard about before, it could be a good refresher, and then some of the things are totally new that I haven't really talked about before. So I hope that you guys enjoy, and let's get started. My first tip slash hack is to keep your kitchen space clean and organized. This is a huge one for me because I love being in my kitchen. And when I go into my kitchen, I want to feel inspired and motivated. I don't want to go in there and then just see like a bunch of dishes piled up, or you know, stains on the table, or things like not being beautiful. Like, I love to be in an environment that is peaceful, calm, organized, so that I can find the things that I need. And you definitely don't need to have a perfect kitchen. It doesn't have to be, you know, your dream kitchen at the moment. For me right now, mine is not, but I've tried to make it as beautiful as I can make it and work with what we have. So even adding things like a plant, a nice crystal, some nice organizational jars and things that you can put your dried goods in, all of these things really make a big difference just aesthetically to how your kitchen looks. I'm generally pretty good with this, but the one part of my kitchen that I was just having very difficult time with was my spice drawer. So I recently went through it. I'll actually show you a before clip right here, and you can see that we had a bunch of different spices from different brands and different packaging, and it was starting to get really frustrating. So I took everything out, I cleaned out the drawers, and then I got these really great glass spice jar containers on Amazon. So I transferred all the spices into those jars, and then I printed labels on my Dymo machine, and I labeled them on the top so that I could see, you know, which spice is which. And it worked out beautifully. I love what it looks like now. It is so beautiful and so organized. It makes me so happy. And it's just so much easier now to find the spices that I need. And of course, you can apply this to any other part of your kitchen, whether you want to organize your utensils better, your produce, like your fruit that you maybe keep on the counter, or your kitchen tools, like your blender or your kettle or toaster, whatever it is, just make it as beautiful as you can. Keep it clean, keep it sanitized, and you will love to be in your kitchen more, which means you'll be preparing better food for yourself, less takeouts, less restaurants, and things like that. My second hack slash tip, this is something that I've been doing a lot more lately and I love it, and that is to truly connect with your food as you are eating it. And also, if you prepared your food, to really put love and good intention into your food as you are making it. So I'm someone who loves to either listen to a podcast or audiobook or watch a YouTube video as I'm eating, if I'm not eating with someone else, of course. But recently I've just been sitting with my food. I haven't been watching anything. I've just been really trying to connect with each bite that I have and really appreciating the food, because if you think about it, it's actually quite amazing how all of that food came to your plate, the amount of time that it takes to grow that food, all the sun and the rain and all the days that it took to grow, and then of course the farming of that food, the transportation of that food. Actually getting it onto your plate is a huge feat, and it's beautiful when we can really acknowledge that and see that. So connecting with your food just means to really look at it, appreciate it, see the beautiful colors, and when you're chewing your food, you know, feel the different textures and the different flavors, and really be there. I think think for a lot of us, we can just kind of shove food in our mouth very quickly, especially if we live busy lives. But it's actually really beneficial to properly chew your food and not eat too fast. It takes about 20 minutes for our stomach to signal to our brain that we are full and satiated. I've personally experienced times where I have something like super delicious, like a nice cake or dessert, or even just like a meal, and we're sitting on the couch and watching a movie, and literally the thing can be gone in like a few minutes because I'm so distracted by watching the TV and I think like, where did all my food go? I would highly recommend trying this out, even if it's just for the first few bites of your food. Another thing on this topic is you could also get some beautiful bowls and different, you know, plates that again just make the food feel a little bit extra special and beautiful, and that again just gets you excited about cooking and enjoying your food. I recently got these beautiful plates in these beautiful like light blue kind of gray colors, and I just love them so much. Every time I look at them, I'm like, wow, this is so pretty, and it just makes again the whole experience that much better. My third hack slash tip, this is something else that I've been doing recently that I found really, really helpful, and that is to try to finish having dinner by around 6:30 or 7 o'clock in the evening and not be like snacking too much beyond that point. The reason I mention this is because for a pretty long time I was in a not so good habit. I think it definitely had to do with quarantine, because we were having these really beautiful evenings, like it was really nice. We would have dinner and then we would sit and watch a movie, and then we would get snacks and desserts and things like that, and we would literally be eating until like 9:30 at some points, and then I would try to go to bed at like 10 or 10:30 with this really full belly, and I would not feel my best. I find that I sleep a lot better now. I sleep a lot deeper. Also, if you are trying to lose weight or you just want to maintain a healthy weight, there's actually a lot of science and research behind this. The saying, eat breakfast like a king, lunch like a prince, and dinner like a pauper. There's actually a lot of evidence to that when it comes to healthy weight management or weight loss, if that is your goal. There's a few really great videos on nutritionfacts.org. Dr. Michael Greger, he talks about this, and it's so fascinating. There's actually a study where they had overweight women eat the same amount of calories, but one of the group of women, they ate most of their calories in the morning and over lunchtime, and then a smaller dinner. And then the other group of women had most of their calories in the evening time. So a smaller breakfast, a medium lunch, and then a big dinner. So same amount of calories, just dispersed differently throughout the day. And the group of women who ate most of their calories in the morning actually lost 2 times the amount of weight as the women eating most of their calories in the evening. Again, this was the same amount of food, same type of food, same calories, just dispersed differently. If you want to learn more about this, I will have the nutritionfacts.org videos below in the description box. They are super, super interesting. And I know this kind of contradicts a lot of what intermittent fasting is about, where most people tend to skip breakfast and then, or just delay breakfast and then have, you know, breakfast, lunch, dinner, like within a shorter window of time. A way to tweak this to your advantage and to still gain the benefits of chronobiology is just to switch the times a little bit more forward. So to start your day with breakfast, like in a normal time, and then just try to finish dinner by around 6 or 7 o'clock so that you give your body enough time to digest the food before you go and sleep. But overall, I find that this has been really helpful in just allowing me to sleep better, sleep more deeper, and not feeling like super uncomfortable when I'm going to bed. My fourth hack slash tip when it comes to health and wellness, this is probably one of the most important ones when it comes to really staying on track with eating well, and that is to pre-cook or meal prep some of your staple foods. So some of my staple foods are quinoa, brown rice, potatoes, both regular potatoes and sweet potatoes. So these are things that you can make in the beginning of the week and then just keep eating them throughout the week. So for example, quinoa and brown rice are great to just keep in Tupperwares, and then I like to bake sweet potatoes and then I put them in my fridge and just warm them up in the oven. And I do the same with white potatoes, although I will steam my white potatoes. I'll put them in either a Ziploc bag or in a Tupperware. I again keep that in my fridge, and before I'm ready to eat them, I just take them out, slice them up, put them on a baking tray. They go in the oven on convection roast. They get nice and crispy. And as those potatoes are in the oven, I will prepare myself a salad. And it is so quick and easy and delicious and filling and nutritious. And when it comes to brown rice or quinoa, they are great to have with salads or with buddha bowls. They just keep so well in the fridge for about, like, I would say 4 or 5 days. You know, they might last longer, but we tend to just eat them up by that point. Beans are another great thing to pre-cook, or you could just get canned beans. Those are completely fine as well. But just having staple foods in your fridge, you could even slice up like salad ingredients like cucumbers, or you could shred carrots or celery or whatever it is that you like to put into your salads. Just keep them already pre-cut, and when you are ready to eat, you just throw it all together and it's super easy. You can do the same thing with salad dressings. And also, if you are cooking a soup or a curry or something delicious and warm like that, just make an extra big portion, and you can even freeze some of that. That's actually what I've done recently with a chili that I made. So that is now in our freezer in a Tupperware, and when I want to eat it, we just take it out, let it thaw, you know, put it back in a pot, and it's good to go. This way, when you're tired and you have absolutely no motivation to cook something, you just take whatever you have in the fridge out, you warm it up, and you're set. So always have good options on hand. That is a big one. And my fifth hack slash tip, this is to have a solid morning, and if you can, evening routine. But the morning routine is really important. A morning routine does not have to be, you know, 10 steps or even 5 steps. It can be as simple as knowing what you're gonna have for breakfast, and maybe a good workout as well. Like, those are two, I think, really important things. So literally, if you know that tomorrow morning you're gonna wake up, you're gonna go for a walk, or you are gonna do a Pilates class at home, or you're gonna do a spinning class at your gym, or you're gonna do a gentle yoga, whatever it is, you just know that that's something that you wanna do in the morning, and then you know that you wanna have a nice bowl of oatmeal, or you're gonna have a big, beautiful green smoothie. Those two very simple things alone, that can really change how the rest of your day unfolds, because if you do something like that, it sets the tone for the day and it puts you in a good, positive momentum. And I can almost 100% guarantee you that when you start your day this way, you'll want to continue to do good things for yourself. These things really set you up to have a good day, and it becomes like a strong pillar that you can rely on. And especially if you also do it in the evening times, so if you have like a nice kind of wind down routine in the evenings. I know that life can get really crazy, and especially right now, we're still in this very different and sometimes eerie environment with everything going on in the world, and it can feel very disabling. But what you can choose is how you live your life, and especially when you have those, you know, good morning pillar and like a good evening pillar, whatever happens in between, then whether you have ups or downs, you know that you can always rely on those two solid foundations. And that is what I think is really, really helpful and can keep you on a positive track in the long term. In the beginning, you might need an extra bit of motivation to actually get yourself there, but the more you keep doing this and the more that you feel the amazing benefits that it has on your body, the more it will become automatic and like habitual, and you'll find that you just crave those things naturally. I know we said 5 tips, but I'm gonna give you guys an extra little bonus one. So my bonus tip is to make moving part of your lifestyle. So what I mean by that is, for example, if you can bike somewhere instead of driving a car, then do that. Or if you don't have a bike, or you just physically can't bike to wherever you need to go, then just parking your car just a little bit further away from your destination than you would normally do. And I don't mean like you have to park it like crazy far, but you know, if you have a parking space very close to the entrance, or there's a parking space just a little bit further away, try to park in the one that's just a little bit further away so that you can just infuse your day with more natural movement. I also apply this concept to when I can either take the stairs or the escalator or the elevator. I will take the stairs. Mo thinks I'm crazy for doing this. A lot of the times he's like, why would you take the stairs? But I tell him, we have legs and they want to be used. And I love getting in a little bit of extra movement, and I know that it's great for my body. It makes me feel good. Another way to implement this is if you are meeting up with a friend and maybe you generally like to go and, you know, sit down somewhere and have some food or something like that. Another great thing you could do is to go for a walk or to go for a hike and catch up that way. So it doesn't always have to be, you know, sedentary, like sitting down. This is something that I've always loved to do. I love to meet my girlfriends and we go for a walk, or again, we go for a hike. And it's just so beautiful to get out into nature, to breathe fresh air, especially if you are home a lot, and just get moving. And that's another great way to just infuse your day with natural movement. So those are the health and wellness hacks that I wanted to share with you guys in this video. I really hope that you enjoyed. I would love to know what some of your health and wellness hacks are. Let me know down below in the comments. Again, make sure to check the description box down below for links to different videos and maybe recipes that I showed in this video or other helpful information. And I hope that you're all having a beautiful day. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next one.